Are you looking for some inspiration in your next presentation that you need to do? Good, I hope so too, because if I'm going to be sitting watching it, I do not want to see the same presentation over and over again. So, which is why I recommend this website. So pitch.com. I have no affiliation. They've not paid me any money. I wish they had. I just like the website, in all honesty. I think it's a really good tool. So what do? Well, they make nice presentations, or as they put it, stunning presentations. Okay, you can essentially work with someone else in your team to build a presentation together. We'll talk more about that later, because there's different subscription models. But look at these things, you know, it's that looks good. Okay, that looks better than your presentation. I've not even seen it, but I know it looks better than your presentation. So pitch.com, let's just actually go down to the bottom. Let's go to pricing. So starter, so this is free, unlimited presentations, unlimited members, custom templates and fonts, live video collaboration and recordings. Then you've got a pro feature, which has got all of that, and analytics. What else? We've got guest sharing, so you can send it to someone externally, custom links, version history. Yeah, that's quite important. Private folders and so forth, also video and image library. Not so worried about that because there's so many free things out there as well. And export to PowerPoint. Now this is, that's maybe worth the £8 to be able to export to a PowerPoint, depending on what you're doing in your organization. And then finally, we've got the enterprise model, but let's not even talk about that. Right, let's sign in. Let's see what it's all about. I'm gonna sign up. Never used this before. I could, let's do continue with Google. Let's sign into one of my accounts. I agree to data protection. Does anyone not tick that type of thing? Okay, let's get to know you. Okay, you'll mostly use Pitch for work. There we go, I'll use it for work. What's my role? Leadership. What's the company size? It's that one there, 2 to 10. Next. Create a new workspace. Let's call it test one so it stands out. Let's create a workspace. Invite your teammates to do this as well. Okay, I won't do anyone, but you know, I'll skip for now, but that is how you do it. Looks very easy. Also, anyone with that email address, so ending with that, anyone in my organization could do this as well if I tick that box. I won't, let's just skip for now, but it looks like a very good feature. Almost there. Before you go, would you like to receive email tips and tricks? Let's be honest, I don't. Probably is useful, they'll probably tell me with some new template out, but let's just start using Pitch. Here we go. Ah, I can import a presentation, I can explore the template library, or I can create a new presentation. Now this sounds good. Import presentation sounds pretty awesome. But let's have a look. Let's explore the template library or gallery. Okay, I'm already impressed with this. This already looks better than the things I want to do. So let's go with that first one there. Let's go for the sales pitch one. I'll click on the template to view it. Oh, you can narrow it down as well, so I can use one of these ones. Oh, let's have a business one, the UX strategy one. Okay, let's go back to all. I like this one. I know it's the first one, but I do like this. And I'm gonna use this template. Right, what we got here? We've got templates on the side. We've got add a slide, so we've got one slide at the moment. We've got templates. This is the template. It is blank at the moment. If I right click on this, it's a website, but you can actually right click on it. That's quite interesting. So new slide, skip a slide. Could copy, paste, etc, etc, etc. Copy the link. Okay, so what I want to do now, I want to actually get that template that we saw earlier. So I'm gonna go to add slide. And let's go with that one there, sales pitch. Look at that. Okay, so I don't want it to be sales pitch. I want it to be create action. That's my company name. It says company name now, but let's put my name in there as well. There we go, let's go with that. Let's just delete that. I don't know what it was, but let's get rid of it. There you go, delete that. Q3. Let's go for page one. Well, that looks good, doesn't it? So that is the imagery. I can't do anything with the imagery, but I can certainly change all of this. Let's add a shape in here as well. Let's add a star. Oh, that was easy. Clicking on the star, I can fill it in. Pick a color. There you go. A nice star. Now, there we go. Let's put that there. In fact, that star looks terrible. But you can see, well, you can see that it's working. Let's add a slide there. Let's go for a new slide. So we got one slide here, we got add a slide, and let's go for company overview. So there we go, company overview. Let's leave that there. Create action was created in 2016. Yeah, there we go. Company overview. Got an image here, I can replace the image. So I can look for an image here from Unsplash, Giphy, any of these, or I can upload media. Let's have a look at uploading media. So let's grab one of my images. Oh, there we go. That's easy to do. Now you can see why I'm starting to enjoy this. This is actually really useful, really powerful. I can share it with someone as well. Click share, share options. But you can instantly put together, oh, that's me playing it. Let's just go back to that. To play the PowerPoint, well, better not call it PowerPoint, to play the pitch.com, click on this play icon here. So if you're gonna go to a job interview or something and you want something a little bit inspirational, go with pitch.com. It's looking better than the PowerPoint alternatives I've seen. You can see how easy it is to edit things. I can add a chart in there as well. I can modify the data, so you know, change what those ones are, put in the new figures in there as well. I'm going to undo that, click this icon up here, or Control Z, there we go, undo. It automatically saves because it's you know, it's web-based, so it's already saving my project. If we go back to, let's go to this workspace here, so click on the back arrow. What do you learn about pictures? Ignore that for the time being. Go to my workspace down here. And we've got this one here already in place, that's what I was creating. So anyway, that's pitch.com. I think it's good. You know, easy to use, good website. You saw how quick it was to pick up and use. If you're looking to do some kind of presentation, then it's looking like a pretty good option to me. Anyway, if you found this useful, subscribe to my channel, like the video. If I find anything useful, I kind of save it in a folder called Cool Tools, and I create videos about it because, you know, I like to share these things. I'm all for that whole no-code thing where instead of trying to be some really technical person, which I'm not, I like to use tools that other people have created to be able to, in this case, you know, create really good, impressive, you know, presentations very easy. So, you know, I recommend pitch.com. There's other websites I recommend as well. Anyway, subscribe, like, thank you very much.